एंड स्टार्टअप पॉलिसी। दिस पॉलिसी इज फॉर स्टूडेंट्स एंड फैकल्टीज ऑफ हायर एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूशन एंड दिस विल एनेबल द इंस्टीट्यूट्स टू एक्टिवली एंगेज स्टूडेंट्स फैकल्टीज एंड स्टाफ इन इनोवेशन एंड इंटर्नशिप रिलेटेड एक्टिविटीज। दिस फ्रेमवर्क will also facilitate Ministry of Education, formerly known as Human Resource Development, in bringing uniformity across HEIs in terms of intellectual property ownership management, technology licensing, and institutional startup policy, thus enabling creation of a robust innovation and startup ecosystem across all HEIs. Now moving ahead, I would like to invite a man with limitless human potential, one who is round the clock engaged in enhancing excellence in teaching, learning and research. He is the one who strongly believes hard work pays off. He is none other than Professor Rakesh Kumar Dwivedi, Director and Principal, Faculty of Engineering and Computing Sciences. He is a committed and dedicated professional with a proven ability to teach, motivate, and guide students. He has a wide and rich experience of research from IIT Roorkee. We need not to say very much about him. The whole TMU campus vibrates and echoes his prominence. Without further delay, I request our guiding source, Professor R.K. Dwivedi, sir, to enlighten the attendees.
Thank you, Madam Sakshi.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. I'm thankful to you. You set a very good platform. And for Dr. Pankaj. Dr. Pankaj, namaskar.
Good morning, sir. Good morning,
Pankaj. Good morning, sir. Good morning.
So,
good morning, sir.
Good morning. Friends, first of all, my warm greetings of good morning to each one of you. Friends, this National Innovation and Startup Policy, Government of India, Ministry of Education has set for students and for faculty members of higher educational institution. And this could be a guiding framework. This could be a guiding framework to what I can say enable to enable the institutions to actively engage students, faculty colleagues, and the staff members, especially lab technicians and other scientific officers, programmers, and in innovation activities. The basic agenda is basically the concept which is launched by Honorable Prime Minister of India and ably supported by other HEIs, Atmanirbhar Bharat. So how India become Atmanirbhar, self-resilient? Once innovation could be flourishing at every label. In fact, if I talk about in quantified way, it has to be initiated by the educational institution and at engineering institution level. This is the objective of AICT, MHRD, and in nutshell, we have to spread this information to initiate a good startup, because this is the era of technological era, we can say, technology transformation era, where entrepreneurial activities has to be uplifted, and we have to understand the innovation model, because if we say the worldwide index, if we see, India is at not in very promising situation. Why India is not in very promising situation? Because we have not created a such kind of dynamics. or ecosystem where innovation can take place. In fact, we are very good worker, dedicated worker. But now we have to move ahead. We have to create a environment where our thought has to be uplifted from worker to entrepreneurial label. This is the objective of Government of India, and for FOE and CS, Dr. Pankaj is today's resource person who could take it from end-to-end solution, I can say. And for creating this platform, many back-end people are working day and night. My worthy colleague Pradeep Kumar Verma ji, who is the president of Indian Institution Innovation Council for Faculty of Engineering, Mr. Manish Dhingra ji, Dr. Manish Dhingra ji, head of the Department Mechanical Engineering, Dr. Garima Goswami ji, who is the head of the Department of Electrical Engineering, Madam Sakshi Singh, coordinator and senior faculty of Department of Electronics. All these engineers are working hard to create this environment, to create this dynamics, and to provide a better platform for our engineering students. In fact, I am happy to announce that this year, 4 teams were the finalists in software, Smart India Hackathon, which is the noble initiative of Government of India, Ministry of Education, with joint collaboration of MHRD and AICT. And one team has reached to the pinnacle in hardware edition, and 3 teams has reached to the software edition. And out of these 4 teams, 2 teams, Team Tech Hacker and Team Techno Hacker. Team Tech Hacker from CCSI, from Faculty of Engineering, has won this Smart India Hackathon Software Edition prize of rupees 1 lakh. So these are the indications we are getting that our direction is pretty good. Our classroom model is exceptionally good. Our students' project label are increasing multifold, and by those projects, we are going for patent as well. Our publications are increasing, research publications are increasing manifold. So by all these practices, I hope the future is pretty bright, and our students are ably becoming a successful entrepreneur. There is a multiple list. Students are have launched a very good car parking model. One of the engineering, electrical and electronics engineering and computer science students have jointly worked on this model. This is the noble phenomena for car parking, and many more. This is, I am sharing this year performance. So my best wishes to the team.
Ho gaya?
Abhi to hona rahe hai, itni der se hum kar rahe
hain. My best wishes to the team led by Mr. Pradeep Kumar Verma ji for IIT, supported by Madam Sakshi, Dr. Garima, Dr. Pankaj, Vipin, Dr. Manish Dhingra ji. So thank you very much. I wish you all the best for the session.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for enlightening us. Now I would like to invite Dr. Pankaj Kumar Goswami, our keynote speaker. He is an associate professor in the Department of ECE, FOE and CS, Tirthankar Mahavir University, Muradabad. Dr. Pankaj Kumar Goswami has received his BTech, MTech and PhD degree in the area of electronics engineering with vast teaching experience of 15 years in reputed organizations. He has more than 30 international publications in the reputed peer-reviewed journals, including IEEE Explorer, Scopus, and SCI Indexed. He is a potential reviewer of reputed journals, conferences, indexed in Scopus and Web of Science. His main area of research is the machine learning, Internet of Things, wideband antenna design, cognitive radios, and power quality issues in non-linear electronics devices. He has organized several national and international conferences, symposia, and webinars. Dr. Goswami has also published several patents in the field of antenna design, Internet of Things, machine learning-based applications under the intellectual property rights of Government of India. He is an educator in the field of machine learning using Python. He is actively associated in NAC SSR preparations at universities interface and visited several times SAARC countries, Nepal, Bhutan, and several sisters for various academic promotional activities. He is a professional member of several national and international bodies. Dr. Goswami has been involved in various educational outreach activities through online sessions on artificial intelligence, machine learning, and smart antenna. Welcome you, sir.
Well, thank you very much, ma'am. Saksham, really, you cited a lot. Definitely, I was enjoying myself. thank you very much, sir. And first of all, I'm highly thankful for the Pradeep sir for just definitely creating such a great platform. And just he's doing a lot of hard work always related with the IIZ activities. So my sincere gratitude to you. And exactly the force behind sir, our respected director, Professor R. K. Dwivedi, he is always just keep on igniting the people that now it is a chance to do that. And definitely he's also a driving force. So, I don't have exactly too much words to just appraise him regarding to his enthusiasm and zeal related with his activity and his ideas that exactly is somewhat related with the innovation. So if I feel at entrepreneurship and as well as the innovation, then definitely keeps in his mind. So this is exactly, sir, thank you very much. So always just keep us igniting, keep us the team igniting always to work in this direction. So, well, we are limited with the time and the topic if we talk about, it's not only restricted within a period of like a couple of minutes here, but exactly this is a kind of a, you know, a motivation. This is a kind of an ignition that has to be created within a person. That's important. So as I'm here, I'm just working as an NISP coordinator for the FOE, and I have a responsibility to definitely interface all kind of motives that are created by the MIEC, Ministry of Education, who is just working in the direction of innovation side and creating such kind of activities for the higher education institution. They are basically HEI. I'm just starting with my slides, not taking up much time. Well, here we have basically this orientation session related with the NISP. So first of all, important part, like here we have the faculty member as well as the students too. So we have basically a single objective, but different pathway. That's the important part. One from the perspective of the student and one from the perspective of the faculty members, those are just going to incorporate their knowledge, their understanding, their hard work in the objective of the AICTE. If we see here, so first of all, we look for the NISP, National Innovation and Startup Policy. So this is all about a great initiative of the MHRD Innovation Cell, which is the MIC. And exactly that is working within the institution under the collaboration of the IIC and exactly governed by the AICTs right now, who is just taking care and just putting a kind of a enthusiasm among the peoples of the India. So those are just taking care about that. Now, what exactly we are here to go for? So this is the purpose to make us understand why it is important and why we should just take participation in that. That's the main part. So let's begin with simple objective. As we know that innovation is the first word. And if we see and we talk about that, innovation is very important, like for any educationist who's working, innovation is important for everyone's life. It is totally not totally depending upon the like, you're working the area of the technical you're working in the area of some management. It's not like that. Innovation is everywhere. Whatever you're thinking, if you are capable to implement it or the real-time application, that's what an innovation. So that innovation is going to benefit the society in any way, that exactly the innovation. So here we have a lot of things that can be a part of innovation, but the problem is here that innovation always just we have inside the mind and definitely that they die. So somebody's already said that one of the worst place of an idea, if I talk about what exactly the worst place for an idea, that exactly the mind. So mind is itself that area. If you keep your idea there, and definitely it is going to die very soon and not going to give any sort of benefit of the society. So important aspect is there, if you have an idea, just try to create some sort of the pitch and the platform so those ideas come into the existence. It might be possible that my idea may not be successful for what thing you are looking for. And because of that fear, it happens many times. You just keep your idea inside your mind. You do not put it out because you feel that there's a great fear that surely it is not going to work. Under this situation, it is important if you have a 4 or 5 times failure, so then that particular failure is going to give an experience to you whether this particular idea will be working and what are basically the loopholes. Until and unless you put it on the ground, it's very similar. Like you are having a cricket match watching on a television or the person who is playing a match on the pitch. So until and unless you will come on a pitch, you will just sit on that particular place where it is exactly to be faced. You would not be able to how to deal with that. It's very simple. If suppose somebody is just having a bat in hand and somebody is bowling and we are watching that match on a television, easily we can say, oh, that's a bad shot. Why is not playing in the way, like why not using the uppercut and something like that, using a drive? But the person who is exactly on the pitch is exactly getting the real-time analysis. And then he is deciding what kind of the failures he is just facing on. So the important thing is here, the innovation comes with the idea. And it does not come if an idea or you just keep in your mind. So important part, we are here to put out your ideas. If you have idea in your mind, now it is a target. Now it is a time to definitely put that idea on a pitch. And where is that pitch? That pitch is exactly your surrounding. If you are a student, wherever you are studying, that is the place to put it out. If you are a faculty member, so exactly by means of your research writing, by means of your patent filing, by means of your execution, that is a place where you just put off your idea. So that's an important part. So if we see here what exactly the objectives of this NISP. So this NISP has an objective to sensitize and orient the importance of entrepreneurship. They're not only working with the innovation, because it happens. Like suppose you have an innovation, might be possible, but meanwhile, that innovation is not being converted into entrepreneurship, so somewhat we are not going to get the benefit exactly in the whole sense. That is another point. If we see here, so that's important. Like if you have an innovation, that innovations need to be converted into the entrepreneurship. So that exactly we would be able to help the economy of India. We are going to work with the help of a growth of an economy of India. So that is an important part. So if suppose second point objective we are looking for to broaden out our understanding on policy design, logic and performance indicator, this is exactly part from the institution side. The first part comes to the person who is dealing with the innovation, who is thinking about it. It's first to get an innovation, create it and try to convert into the entrepreneur. And the second part is there where it is to be worked. Like where is that ground? Where is that platform? This platform is somewhat an institution, somewhat an industry. So now we need to create some sort of policy work, policy kind of a design, so that if an idea is there inside the mind of a student or a faculty of a person or a person, then that particular policy will gonna to help that person to make that idea out and come into existence. The third is the vision and design to development of result oriented innovation entrepreneur. Exactly. Target is exact. We have to create some sort of the product that come out in the market and that is just going to give some commercial benefit. This is exactly the utility. So if suppose I have something in design, like some sort of thing, like I have some, like if I belong to electronics, I have a circuit in my mind and I'm just designing that the particular circuit is going to help us. Like right now we have a winter, so somewhat kind of a circuit I'm going to create that is warming up the room as per the requirement. This is a simple circuit. So thinking is one. Creating a circuit is one, that is what innovation. Writing a research paper on that is another thing. just going to file a patent on this, another thing. And finally, you are just developing your product and selling out in the market is exactly the entrepreneur and getting a back benefit. So here we have an objective to work innovation as well as for the entrepreneurship too. This is exactly the target. And that's important for all of us. Importance, because if suppose we are just keep doing, we are just having a practice and just working on this direction, then we would be able to get ourselves on the global interfaces. If you see here, the Ministry of HRD, specifically MIC, is working and is just creating so many platforms to really represent your innovation and ideas. As sir told to us that we were definitely the finalists, and it's one of the biggest news of year 2020 for us. Like Smart India Hackathon, this is exactly invited by the MIC. Institution Innovation Council, IIC, that all are working. We are itself right now just having this orientation session and igniting session for under this flagship of this IIC. Atal ranking of the Institution Innovation Achievements, wherever, whether you're a faculty member, whether you're a student, if you are in an institution. So where your institution actually exists, that's important aspect. And what are the parameters, measuring and performance parameter on which you can say your education is just going to work for next couple of years with the same reputation and standard right now you have. If suppose we are an institution and we are looking for that, if suppose I'm an alumnus of somewhere, that institution just must keep on growing, because anytime if I'm just putting my degree, if just putting my certificate, so that must have a value even after a couple of years and couple of decades too. So that's an important answer. So ranking is very much important. And who can incorporate to just improve this ranking? Whether just only institution, whether the management, whether the administrative stuff, it's not exactly like that. They are just only a resource person for us. Who is going to create that particular ranking? Student and we people, those are the mentors. Those are the guiding them. So we both have an actual force. Those are going to create such kind of a good ranking of the institution so that we feel proud that we are working in a such kind of an institution which has such kind of a ranking, which is basically a universal and which is giving a universal recognition. That's important. Similarly, if you are going for that next one, under which right now we are talking about for specifically, which is the NISP, that NISP has been created by the AICT, Ministry of HRD itself, and they were just created such policies so that if somebody is looking for some startup, somebody is looking for some kind of an entrepreneurship and kind of an activity is there, under that, they are just giving some policy framework and giving him relaxation and the facilities related with that, so that the particular innovation, that particular startup, we're going to create a maximum benefit of it. And simply, they are having an international hackathon. So if you see here, the MIC cell, which is the MHRD initiative, innovation cell, is working all those directions. Smart India Hackathon, giving a platform for the student. IIC just creating a various kind of awareness activity within the institutions to create awareness about the SIH, create the awareness about the Atal rankings too, and going to create itself an NISP also. So this is exactly the work done by the IIC who is doing that. And simply we are looking to fight against the international hackathons too. So that not only we just have a recognition and we are just only the finalists within the area, but it may be possible. We might be working for the international platforms. So first of all, let's making it this simple, because if suppose we are going to read out any policy, any document, it's much difficult to really understand because it has so many technical aspects and so many challenges are there. But in short, if suppose we are going for work with this, so we have a target here to understand the policy framework. So I'm just concentrating myself completely from all other domains to NISP itself. I'm just here to just only talk about the policy, what exactly the policy and what we are going to get the benefit from this one. So this NISP is exactly related with the startup and entrepreneurship. And startup and the entrepreneurship always comes with some innovations. Suppose you have an idea that is challenging, then only you are going to create some entrepreneurship. It has no challenges. It has definitely not having a greatness as compared to the other competitors already itself in a market, then definitely you're not going to create a portfolio, any investment on time in that particular thing. So important aspect is what? So first of all, here we are looking to create understanding of what kind of a policy framework we have. So entrepreneurship, innovation and economic development. This is the very first aspect. Innovation type. What kind of innovation do we have? What kind of entrepreneurship traits are there? Entrepreneurship would have some sort of the relation with the economic growth, unleashing entrepreneurship, startup development phase, and the requirements. So what are the basically all these kind of things and the requirements are there? So let's understand this simply. If suppose we are looking for this entrepreneurial characteristics, if suppose you're looking for, you have an idea, that's it, very good. But still you don't have an idea how to exactly implement that. So now it requires some sort of the, like some characteristics, some steps are there. So first of all, you require a motivation. And how do you get the motivation? You would be able to get that motivation when you're just discussing your idea with the people around you. So it might be possible if you just go back to the story. So many stories are there right now because you are all working with the Google and you just have all Googles on your fingertips. So I'm not going to just discuss all those stories, what they have just created. Somebody has created just only a solar tree and getting a good benefit. Instead of just implanting all solar panels inside a land areas, it's created a simple tree and getting benefit. Person has created a simple kind of a umbrella. Nowadays, we just have an umbrella, 1 or 2 person can easily get a shelter in that. Suppose one has just created a kind of an umbrella, and that umbrella is gonna to help the people of 5 or 6. This is an innovation, and that is in existence, and the people are getting an entrepreneurship. Similarly, if suppose you go for somebody has created, like nowadays we have a problem with the polythene, we see here. So NV Green is a company who has just created such kind of edible polythenes. It means they are just made up of decomposed organic elements. If suppose you are just putting that particular like somewhere and just dropping out and some animal comes up and eating it, so there's no harm because it is edible. This is an innovation. So there is no limit that innovation is only related with the like a lot of investment and lot of big thinking and industrial setup. It is simply related with your idea and its utility. So if you have points, if you have things with you, now it's important, just put it on table. If you put it on table, then definitely somebody might be there, at least among 4 or 5 people who will be, yeah, you are thinking nicely. But if suppose you do this, this idea would be the better one. The first thing. It might be possible you won't get up always the positive responses. But important point is here, if suppose among 5 or 6 comments, if you are able to get the one comment positive, then you would have a direction where to write next. That's a part. Creative tendency, keep on working on that. So if suppose your idea, that's not only the final shape. You have to incorporate always the new things in it. So keep on conceiving about the things, keep on imagining about the things, and this imagination is gonna to make it more perfect. So till it is just in a market, if suppose you have created something, still you just keep on thinking on that, because you have a lot of examples that those did not have just changes in their ideas and their product definitely vanished out from the market. Another important risk, exactly, important. We have to take about the risk. We have to just take care about it. We have to think about that risk. That this risk is really dominating to all of the situation and all of the conditions. And it is again a cause when an idea is dumped out. And we are not having so much entrepreneurs around us. It happens because it has a great risk. So that you should have a capability to just take the risk. And if I say, who is like most prominent, who can just take the risk? So if you talk about the students, you are studying. At that time, you have your course of studies, you have a lot of chance to take the risk. Because you have a certain focus area to just complete your degree. Meanwhile, if you are just putting and implementing your ideas into the form of entrepreneurship activities, so this is a wonderful time for you. You can create it. Because you are one of the best position, one of the safest position where you can just take the ring, because you have years to become a stable person. As long as you would be in a job, as long as you will be just a settled person, and definitely at that time, you will have a lot of thinking and the risk factor will keep on increasing. So before completion of your course, completion of your degree, you have a great chance to start your ideas. And like the members associated with you, the members around you, the mentors around you, they are the resource person. They can help you. They can create a such kind of a group where they can minimize your risk during your education system. So this is another aspect. And the most important, like the control. If suppose we are just going in somewhere, some direction, and we are finding that particular is not going to work with us, so definitely a control strategy is there. So definitely a mentorship is there, and the mentorship is going to work with the help of the research, with the help of the different kind of a market traits, different kind of analysis and analytics are there. They will help you. If I suppose conclude all these part are there, so if we have something, because see, we have a target to create something. If suppose we are working and we are talking about, we people are just paying a couple of hours or some minutes are here on this NISP. So definitely it has an objective that something should come out. That something should come out from the participants in the form of some entrepreneurship activity or in the form of some innovative activity. So important part. So if you have an idea, talk and discuss with your most reliable peoples. They are your mentors. They are going to create a motivation in you. Similarly, you would have a chance. If suppose you are thinking in a direction, you are the best person who can think more on that. Keep on thinking, do not stop it. Risk, your mentor will going to help again with the risk analysis as well as your family members. They're definitely telling you, suppose somebody is in a situation like who needs immediately a job after completion of the course in that condition. So immediately after that, you just go for the job. So that is what the risk analysis. But before that, you have a chance to think and to work and to create a pre-platform for that. So that if you have a planning something that you can work on. And similarly, the control aspects. So we have a basically productive and unproductive entrepreneurship. This productive and unproductive entrepreneurship is directly related with the particular thing which you have just already created, the idea that you have just converted into the form of some product. This is exactly giving a perfection in the response for what it was thought of. For what? So what was behind that? What the idea behind that, and what kind of objective and the benefits were thought at that time, if it is giving or not. So we have so many productive and unproductive, and see, if suppose in the day hours we think upon that, so many productive and unproductive ideas comes in our mind. And if we are doing something, we are executing, we are performing on that, then some of the ideas is giving some sort of the result. It happens every day in a life. Suppose you are in a home and you are having some idea to just to look into your room, and you're finding some things are not in a good position. And then you started, you just pushed up yourself and started working in the direction and making this thing particularly correct. Anything is like that. That's a productive idea that comes in your mind and you execute it. And somehow we have some unproductive ideas also, and unproductive ideas just creating, like if you say, you're creating a such kind of a lobby and talking negatively about the peoples and talking negatively about the systems like that. What is happening around? Just only talking negatively and just somewhat unproductive entrepreneurship. So we should keep avoiding all these kind of things. So the thing which is going to create some productive things, we should work on. So this is actually the force behind the motivation. If you have more frequency of this unproductive entrepreneurship within you, and definitely this productive entrepreneurship will not have a proper motivation, and that will not come to the execution. So we are definitely, as this is exactly the for the institution as well as the entrepreneur, those have established their entrepreneurship activity. And finally, now they are directly related with the economy. Economy growth is related with that. So whatever you are just doing, you are just growing yourself, you are just having your own economic growth. You are just giving that economic growth to your society. You are just giving itself, your city, as well as to the nation itself. This is directly associated with that. It's not like a different aspect that you are a successful entrepreneur and you don't have an economic growth like that. No, exactly. This is a very simultaneous phenomenon. Proportionality is absolutely there. So that will be keep on coming. So important part, role of entrepreneurship and entrepreneurship in economic development, what we can do. Capital formation, obviously, it helps us. This is all basically somewhat related with the financial terms and terminologies. Those are related with that. So if you are a student, so you just know only one thing. It's very simple. If suppose you have something, a product in your hand, exactly. If this is a successful entrepreneurship, entrepreneurial activity, then exactly it has a proportionality with the economy. That has no doubt. And if it is definitely not proportionate, not just giving a economic growth and a development, then definitely it's not a successful entrepreneurship. So that's what important one. So we have a basically unleashing entrepreneurship, private sector development. So we are looking to just work with the economic environment, social environment, type of skill and the technical knowledge, family background, it all depends upon religious and the cultural affiliation, financial condition, availability of the support, psychological, government policy and the political environment. If you see here, so what are the factors basically going to affect your motivation? What are the factors going to affect? Mute karein aap apne aap ko. Like organize somebody, please take care about that.
Yeah, sir, manage.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay.
So the key, simple. It's very, very simple. So many words are there. So many complexities are there. If we have a discussions here, then definitely it should have some sort of the ignition itself. And if we see, if we find out that we all know that if suppose we are talking about the entrepreneurship, so what are the factors affecting us? Obviously, economic environment, most important. Aaspaas kya hai? Kitna paisa milega? Kahan se milega? Kya support milega? That's important part. Social environment, where we are living on. We think we are in Moradabad right now. What we can do here? Suppose we have been in NCR in Delhi. So we will having more resources and more facilities are there. And then we can go easily for the industry. Somewhat we are near the industrial areas. So that is a thinking that happens. That is demotivating us. Type of skill and technical knowledge. You are thinking to just create a product which is going to use for some kind of a plastic bags. And you're working in the engineering background. You're thinking whether I have a skill of designing of that or not. So this is a kind of a match. So in such case, you may create a such kind of a groups also. So we are the different kinds of people can incorporate their information, the knowledge to create or to develop a particular idea that you're exactly thinking about. Family background is exactly a matter that always there's all we want, safe job. That's it. Simple, no risk, exactly whatever we are just getting, that's much and sufficient for us. Yeah. We are getting in the early stages of a simple and some amount, that it's okay. Just keep on growing slowly, slowly. Not a big deal, but don't take a risk. That's exactly some what happens to family backgrounds. Religious and the cultural affiliation, that's also. From where, from which particular religion we belong, that also the matters. It happens that it is from our centers, we are not doing. You have just already heard about that. Humne kabhi business kiya hi nahi, humare yahan kabhi business hua nahi, job hi hua. It's like that. So various kind of cultural affiliations are there that restrict you. Financial conditions, availability of the supporting facilities, exactly, that's important. Psychology. In sabse zyada agar main kisi ko overpower maar dun, that is exactly the psychology and the perception. So if you feel that perception is not working properly, not just giving you an idea and click, or right now, right, what is a kick, is not giving a kick, then definitely nothing will go wrong. So if we are thinking upon, if suppose we have 100 of the students, 1,000 of the students are there, so 10% of the student might start thinking about that. That I have an idea now, I have that idea and I'm just putting my idea on the pitch. And where is that pitch? That pitch is nearby you, which is nearby in the form of your teachers, in the form of your mentors, in the form of your family members, in the form of your friends, maybe anyone like that. This is the one aspect. So if suppose we go for entrepreneurship, so what we are having, so basically we are having some pillars of the entrepreneurship and the foundations, basically, because we are working in the private sector. So as far as we faculty members are here, like those are going to create this one. So they need to understand this exactly the what is the private sector and the pillars of this one. So all of these are working for the fair rules, fairly enforced, access to financial resources. That's an important aspect. We need to understand about that. If we are in a certain private sector, so what exactly do we need for that? We need access of a skill. We need financial resources and we need exactly a kind of environment in which we have our rules and policies like that. Because if we created something and we are not just getting a certain kind of a financial resources to just stabilize that, and we are not just getting a fair rule for that. So NISP, this is basically specifically dedicated to those other faculty and administrative members are there. This is exactly very much important. That's why the Ministry of HRD said that every institution must create its own policy so that under that domain, their peoples, their thinkers might have a fair rules and the fair kind of a thinking so that they have a pre-planned system. Now we have that particular condition, the constant. Under these conditions, the constant, we are going to work with that. That is exactly the policy of the Ministry of HRD. So those are very important. So skill and knowledge, financial resources, and fair rules. That's important. And start up the ecosystem framework. So we go for that. It is definitely having a great structure, how it is going to work. So we have a student innovation and student startup. We always focus on that because we feel that this is one of the safest area. And who is going to take over that? Their institution, their faculty members, those are working on that. So the collaborative effect can be done. So if we have a student innovation and a startup, we see here, that can create the student enterprises and definitely inter-institutional partnership and the network with the regional and the national startup ecosystem. This tells you if suppose within the university, within the Tirthankar Mahavir University, if suppose any small startup has been created and that is to be called as a student innovation. Now that innovation is converted into the form of some small startup and that startup will be created as an innovative student enterprise. Now this student enterprise to be incorporated with what? Would be some national interfaces also. Suppose we have a chance to convert and connect it with the Indian interface, that's wonderful. But at least we should come with the national interfaces to create an ecosystem. So where that particular product may be absorbed somewhere, what is we are going to create? So if we have, and that requires what? That requires some things. If we go for all these blue pillars, the blue pillars are going to make you understand that innovation development is the one pillar. And the second, if you're going for entrepreneurship, exposure and the skill development, then only this innovation student enterprise will be working on. Technology commercialization, it means the patent filing is there. Startup services, support facilities. So all these four pillars are required to create innovative student enterprise. And then we can work with the ecosystem. So this is the basically four pillar system. So we have to take care about that. If we are a student, so what we are looking for? We are looking for innovation development, we are looking for environment. So students, you have that environment, you can work with that. We are here to create some kind of some facilities and we are here to come up with the policies itself for you so that you may start a better and you can create your own innovative student enterprise. Startup development phases, suppose like you are thinking, now you just have some initiative, like this, we have a so much complex talk that is required, that is required. Now coming up with that, you have a certain thinking in your mind. Like if you think, yeah, we can have some startups, we can have some thinking like that. So what are the basically things required for that? So first of all, startup knowledge, money and connections, important part. So you should have first. So if you are the student, so you just only focus on the first thing, which is the startup knowledge. Knowledge, what you are looking for. You just go for this knowledge part and the money and the connection, you should work with your team. Whatever the team you have, whether you have few student in your team, whether you have few faculty members, some peoples, those are related with your area already itself, your brother, your sisters, those are working itself. Whomsoever is there, is a part of a team, let them this assignment to complete money and connections. And the person who is just thinking, who has an idea, they should have a proper understanding of startup and knowledge, must work. Public services and the funding, private service and the funding process and investor. Somewhat, if you feel your project is too good, you can find out the investors too. That will be applicable. So here you have a good chance to work upon that because you would be, if suppose your idea is so good. So many things are there within the institution level. We have policies that can help you. If we go for like here and startup and development phase, key stakeholders, what are these? So let's think upon that, what exactly the required thing is here. So if we go here, if you see, very simple. If you go for business idea. Yeah. So first you see here we have this idea, then we have a team. If you see here, this one idea, and we have a team, we have this converted into four sections, business and the organization. If you see, first of all, idea always comes when you are in a higher education generally, but not, this is not exactly the universal truth. So again, I say you people are just working the era of the Google. So if you just go and type on Google, you would be able to see how many kids were there in the early stage of the schooling. They have just developed so many good ideas and they are working on that and they have become a successful entrepreneur itself. Yeah, but exactly, they have idea, but the idea was incorporated and held by the people around them, that exactly the people. So first, you have basically some ideas, research, IPR and ideas, go for this. So if you are having some patent filing processes are there, so that you think you are having a capability to just do something. So it's a very first stage. You create your idea. So in India, we have a facility that a particular design and as well as idea can be patented itself. So don't worry about that, that something should be in the physical sense itself. So we can go for the provisional patent filing, that facility we have, and definitely me itself and as well as the whole team will be working in the direction to support you. That's first. So research based IPR. So intellectual property right is there. So idea created, then we are going for a startup. And startup will be converted into the business when we are going to connect with the business. Then we have a big companies and innovations there. So here we require a team, and the team is going to work with the talent, and talent will definitely comes with the people related with your nearby, maybe your classmate, maybe your teachers, maybe in the universities as well as, and then creating an organization, finally going to convert it into business. And meanwhile, in sabke beech mein, there's one more important aspect is the incubation cell. And that soon we are going to develop that. And very soon we have a facility to facilitate other. Like, so those are working with their issues and the problem, and the incubation centers are there. They can develop a small business idea within in that. And they can give the solutions to the outside world like that, and external interfaces there. So startup development phase, if you have, suppose that you're looking for, we have an idea creation, then we have an idea validation, product creation, product validation is there, business model, then business validation. So all those are the later on stage, and for specifically, those are for the mentors. These stages are effective for the mentors and not specifically to be too much like known for the students. Like, you just only think on a startup and innovation like that, but how it is being processed further on, that's important. So the team, founder team formation, team commitment, that's important. Commitment may be verbal, commitment may be some of the legal papers, because it is an entrepreneurship. And when you're just going with this, this is going to be converted into the form of business. And at that time, when it is a business, then definitely it should have a certain commitment. Commitment in form of some writing and papers. So this is again a secondary or the later part, how we are going to make it capitalize all these kind of a things. That's the later part on. Now if we see, that's important. So we, if I'm just picking up back all these things, what we have created, we started talking about why we are focusing on innovation and the startup. What's the important part is there. What to do by the student and what to do by the faculty members. That's an important aspect. Then we have just shifted about what exactly the models and the movements are there. Then after, what are the other frameworks on which it is being measured on? So if we go for, now we have a GII, GEM, GII and ARIA. Basically these are the standard frameworks over which the nation is working out, and all those are giving the ranking. This is not only institutional ranking, but this is the ranking related with the innovation, the startup all around the India. So if suppose, just take an example, if you are just having your course and studies and you just have a certain kind of a startup and the design is there on which you are capable to participate in one of these performance measures, then see what will be your reputation is going to work with that. So So that exactly the motive of today's discussion, the objective of the today's orientation. So we have so many like indices are there. You may find out a lot of working and a lot of work with that, and definitely where we are lying on, what is the India's status, what are the statistics are there. Every analysis analytics are available here. If you see, there's a very, very interesting figure that if suppose you're working this global startup landscape, so India is basically lying in the emergent part. So we are here. Under the emergent, we are just lagging behind from the Israel and as well as the China and UK. But we are emergent. We are not aspirants. That's the positive part. You see here, if we are emergent, not aspirant, emergent, it means we are developing. We have not developed. We are not definitely mavericks. It means we are doing wonders. So UK is, US is just doing that wonders, but even that the UK is on the borderline. China, who is definitely so good and everywhere just finding it, but it is itself in an emergent part, Israel itself. So among them, so this is a very good and positive analysis for us that we are under the emergent. And if we are emergent, it means we have a policy framework with us. It means under the emergent process, we have a chance to develop. Because itself, if suppose somewhere the perfection is already there, then definitely it becomes very difficult to just put ourselves into that. Itself right now, we are working, we are emerging, then during that, there is a possibility that we can just bootstrap our idea as startup better as compared to the Mavericks type situation. This is a very good analysis. And if suppose we are working with the innovation and entrepreneurship activities under that ecosystem we see there. So what is basically the part? Who can just take that? That I've already discussed about that. That age distribution is here. If suppose we have less than 25%, the 21%, 26 to 30%, 31%. That is exactly the development. So those are working in the area of the 26 to 30. Definitely, they have a 31%. Exactly have a thought process started at a time of their early stages. So these 20% would gonna to do work with that. 26 to 30 and 31 to 45 is a 40%, just like that. So education qualification, engineering graduate and the science graduates are doing wonder in that. The MBA people are also working and others are doing. So this is one of the aspects, but not the limitation. This is exactly the analysis that has been done specifically in India, that what is more trending about. So that's come out. So if you are under 25 years, you have a great chance, you have a 20% ability to do that. So among, like, this is exactly like status, statics. Like, suppose we have a lakhs of the students studying, so among them, 20% started thinking before 25 years. That's an important aspect. So you look upon, so what you are doing right now and what is going to be happen once you will be after having an age of 25 years and 31. So many people will be there to just put your competition if you don't think right now. This is giving that advantage. So student startups are there. So if you see in the 2016, 2017, a 1 year gap, 450. So student startup is getting a rise. And as compared to the males and females, we do not talk about that. But I want that a student is a student or gender wise like. So global innovation index is there. We have already talked about where we are lying on. So India is at the 52 rank, 36.58. If you go here and you see, so here we have this 36.58. So we are lying on that. This is all analysis. And exactly if we see here, so we are just gearing up ourselves and getting a good ranks as compared to the previous results. So every time we are just doing well, and every year we are performing well. This is the data comes from the Ministry of HRD. And why we are talking about this data? We are talking about this data because this shows you the motivation within the India about its policy and as well as the facilities. If suppose we don't have a motivation, we have no such kind of a ranking, then definitely it is like that nobody is thinking upon that. So if the peoples are thinking upon that, the higher administrative bodies are thinking upon that, and exactly it has a good chance and good support for us. So same, different kind of analysis are there. If you go for here for working with the entrepreneurship index. So in under so many indexes, we have such kind of a things are there. ARIA, as I already talked to you about it, ARIA is one of the most important ranking for any education institute. Those are having some sort of innovation and achievement this year. So this is exactly, we have a target now. So that's what the target, if suppose our are basically startups or innovations would have a chance to get exact participation in that on the basis of that, and we have a chance to just put ourselves somewhere in the list of that particular ranking, then definitely it's one of the most proud moment for those who has that particular stuff. So if somebody is thinking like that and just trying to convert into the economy and the business profit is there, the first important aspect is there, you should be somewhere in the listing of the RDI itself. Obviously, the toppers will definitely have a good chance to convert all kind of the thinking they have related with their business growth and economies are there. That is another thing. And understanding the market failure, obviously, it may happen because the startups are generated, but because of your a lack of the things and the requirements, it happens everywhere. It happens with the product itself. Even that, if you see here, whether the different kind of a car making companies are there, they launch their new product. If you see within 1 or 2 years, you feel that the particular product is not so much successful. So if they have a 10 products launched in a market, so among 10, only 1 or 2 just doing well and rest has to come back. So that they are doing the innovation. They itself are doing the innovation. Even then, they have a failure. But all those failures are basically taken into the consideration on the basis of analytics. That is the risk analysis that has been taken priorly. If suppose we are going to do that, so what may be the maximum part of the losses, whether we are in a capability to just bear it on or not, that's what. So we have a market failures and different kind of things are there, student, innovation, startup. So this exactly, see, one of the most important for our students as well. Because market failure, if we talk about that, definitely you won't think about that. You no need to think a lot of about that because you just create a product and rest of the things will be taken care of by other people's team members. This is the most important part for you. So now if we go for all this complexities about this startup and this one, so we should work on only 6 P's. What are the first problem? If you go here and then after, so you need to just, this is very important. So among you, if any one of you thinking about this one, just take a screenshot of this one. That's a very, very important. So go for the 6 P's and the 6 P's you find, the first of all, you have a certain problem. If you're looking to outside and you feel that some problem is there, then you would be able to get a particular proper startup and innovation. And the innovation will be converted into the form of some startup. Until and unless you see a problem, your perception should be so much good. Then you would be able to create that. And that must be as simple as possible. Just take an example. Many times we see number of the students are making a project of the blind stick. How many of you think about that to just commercialize it? Why you are not just creating your own blind stick and started supplying to the peoples in your surrounding or somewhat related with the area where you're just taking care of the some kind of the blind peoples. So we can just go there and just make a contact with those peoples to get them sticks. But this is a wonderful project from the couple of the years, and even not couple of the years, even I say the couple of the decades, the students are making the blind stick. And every day I just see that blind stick, I found that some of the innovation has been created. So that's another point, that problem identification, that same blind stick is there, but the innovation has been created. And still if we see, we are not having such kind of a blind stick in practice right nowadays. Even that you find the people's both are the blind nearby, you might be having a simple stick. That's a wood stick, they are using that. So this is one of the area of domain where you can work upon. Similarly, if you see here nowadays, if you see you are having LEDs, charging lamps are there in your home. So why are you not creating such kind of a good combination of the LEDs, making a such kind of a beautiful tree structure like that, so that if somebody is putting at home, that looks so beautiful. And even that it is just providing emergency kind of light when there is a power cut. So another thing is here. So problem identification is more important. But all these things and the creation depends upon your risk analysis. That's what. So here, that's why I'm just saying you have a great chance to just put up yourself, because you have a maximum good conditions to take a risk, irrespective to the others. As I already discussed about that, what exactly happens with that. So problem, first of all, you need to find out your policy implementation. Where you're going to, you need to find out all papers. That's important. you have to think about the price tag. So you have just created a simple blind stick. Now it's important what you are just going to make. You are just going to put with the thousand of bucks of this one. No one is going to look at this. Again, this idea will going to come and entrepreneurship will be again vanished out. So that's important. Price tag. Process. What kind of a process you are going to adopt? How you are just going to? So you are just going to make a contact with the government. You are going to make a contact with some NGO that I have a blind stick. And you people are just taking care of the blind people are there. So let's have a systematic collaboration with us, and we will supply you the blind stick. And on the trade, if you go for the market, you will getting it too much of cost. So we are just providing at a low cost. So that kind of a process development has to be there, and you need to find out the peoples, those are the stakeholders. So there should be one person who can just contact you, or you have a peoples who can create a market for you. This is another. So that's very, very important. So any one of you among like the those are the attendees and the participants thinking upon that, just take a screenshot of this one. It's very important. So we have to go for the policy analysis and something like that. So many things are there again. So among them, I'm not just going to create all of these to make you again a much complex about all this startup policies. Because if you see so many things are there, so it's definitely startup is too typical aspect. It's not like that. Yeah, it has some like pros and cons, but it's not tough. So you see here, if we go for policy analysis toolbox and model, just go to the center, find out. Ensure, construct internal, external validity. Important. Internal and external validity of the product. It means you have a blind stick. I'm just taking a very simple example. If you have a blind stick in your hand, it should have a validity related with its environmental condition, related with its humidity, that's it. Sampling and data collection. So those are how many people are interested and what kind of already blind sticks are available in market. Second thing, limited resources cost analysis. That's important. If we have blind stick in the market of the 300 of bucks, then just take a proper analysis and try to create your own one at the 200 and 250 like that. Consider time and uncertainty. Where, when you are just going to launch that product. That's also important. Sometimes it happens also with the movies because those are planning for that. They just have a great plan because they are also doing some entrepreneurship kind of activities because a new movie is a definitely a new startup. It's obviously the business was running on, but the idea, story, whether it's going to be success or not, right? So they think upon that and they find out a very, very suitable time when it should be launched on. So that's whether you're just going to provide a forecast of this one. You have to go for its quality, always check. Keep on getting the feedback of your system, whether it is working properly. You have to go for your stakeholder analysis, or the who is basically the last beneficiary. You have to talk about all these in between that. Social network is important. You have to go for the political analysis, political environment analysis, what kind of peoples are there, what kind of thinkings are there, whether they are the biased or not, that's all matter. So that's important. And system thinking and the simulation, then finally you create some holistic development of this. So this is exactly all about. So what I just say about that this is basically a kind of a simple conclusion. If suppose you are now proceeding towards your innovation to be converted into the startup, then you have to get all these points. And why I'm just taking all this? Because National Innovation and Startup Policy says that if suppose you are creating all these things, you just put all these things within that particular policy. You should have a certain write-up within your institution, within your system, so that everyone can get the benefit. So that's why I'm just taking care of all these points. If we have a problem tree, exactly, if you see here, first of all, I'm not just going to dictate it a lot. I'm just simply giving a summary to you. If suppose we have a problem tree, first of all, what is the cause? Then find out the sub problem, then go for the core problem, and then finally find out the effect. See what kind of a lack of awareness the people does not know about. That is a kind of a benefit. If they are not aware, that may be a help to your startup. Absence of in-house trained professional, somewhere you have a good things with your hand. The people are not there, those are the skilled and the trained. If suppose I'm just taking this session of orientation session here related with this NISP policy. So why I'm just taking? Because I have a study about that. That's why I just got an opportunity to talk to you related with this NISP. So absence of in-house train. So that might be somewhere possible that you know something that other does not. When the other people seriously don't know about that, in that situation, you may have a better chance to utilize your skills. So that might be a cause. So you need to find out what are the causes are there. Then under these, you may have a sub problems are there. Then you would be having a core problem. What exactly among all these, what exactly the problem you are finding? A person who is basically blind is not capable to purchase a blind stick because he does not have so much of amount of money, or a blind stick is not very adequate. It's not working, not giving a proper sensing, maybe. So go for core problem. Then you would be able to find out exactly the effect on it. So what is a very low self-employable rate is there? What kind of effects are there? So whatever the effects coming out, you may work, you may get a benefit. Similarly, you can create an objective. If you see here, the objective has started from the input resources, going for the activities action, going for the output deliverable, going for the outcome specific objective, going for this vision, and finally creating a final development. So this is again a strategic kind of a point of a vision is here. So my dear faculty members, those are here. So definitely they may have a better benefit of this all kind of objective tree, how they can create all those tree with the help of how they're looking for. First of all, they need the input resources first, then go for the activities and action, then go for the output deliverables and outcomes specific. So keep on working, keep on just finding out all each and every stage by stage process that is going to help. A particular thing which is being created in their mind will be executed into the form of final execution of their vision development. We have so many goals and KPIs related with that. If we see here, so all those KPIs are very much important. We have to go for, we have to find out why we are just doing all this one. So we first, if we see here, these KPIs, if suppose we are talking about, this is specifically my call for the FOE. That if suppose we are looking for this MISP to be implemented here, under this situation, that's important that we should just take care about all these KPI, because we have to come in the form of mains and verification. We have to go for the area. We have to go create a goal. We have to create the outcomes, and all these KPIs are very much important that gonna to help us to create our ranking into the form of some area and as well as the NRIF too. So all of these are there. I'm not going to read all of them, but that shall be provided to you all. So if suppose collectively we have a chance that we people are just working in the direction, so we would be able to complete and fulfill all these KPIs. And on the behalf of these KPIs, key performance indices are there. On the behalf of that, we would be able to participate in some of the good ranking status, and we would have a better institutional ranking as far as the innovation and the other sectors are. So we have a progress monitoring sheets also. So well, taking a little more time about that. So if we go for the policy, what are the basically most important aspect of this policy? First of all, innovation fund, that's important. So how we are going to create, that's an important aspect. What is the policy of that? Whether we are just going to create with the help of some team itself, or the institution is going to create a support of us, because NISP said that we have some facility to create, but it is because it's a startup, then definitely it's going to work. I have some. So, well, that's the important aspect like that. So we have basically an innovation fund and the startup is required for that. So that policy is basically incorporating the facilities that obviously every institution should have some kind of a facilities. But on the basis of the kind of a project and the startup to be developed. So if you have an idea, the policies frameworks are helping you to develop that. Similarly, not only the institutions as well as the Ministry of HRD through their different kind of a projects are working in that direction, then you may easily acquire your fund itself. So academic break for a semester year to the work for this. Yeah, exactly. If you are working so nice, so that kind of a, basically this is NISP adopted by the Ministry of HRD. So Ministry of HRD is saying, that kind of a facility you may also have. Similarly, you must have a share itself. Like if the product is there and definitely institution is there, some partners are there, the sharing is also there, IPR formation is there, and services are there. So all these, if you are talking about under this situation, under this whole situation, we say that the policy has a good component to supporting you in all the way. In all the way, giving a relaxation related to your work, giving definitely a support, helping you, and creating a good rule book for you. If suppose you have an innovation, then definitely you would be a great beneficiary of this. This is one of the highlighting features of the policy. We have more things are there. I'm not going to create all of this one. So taking it up at the end. Well, thank you very much. And meanwhile, if suppose, I'm stopping this one. Just a minute. Stop sharing. So here, in short, again, I'm just concluding the whole session. Why exactly we are here? If suppose somebody has joined late or some is still having confusion, so I'm just concluding this session, and the session will be open absolutely for all to have a discussions on that. So see, important aspect is there. At the institution itself, the university institution has a responsibility to just put themselves as a approved candidate as far as the other things are there. Under these situations, we have to look up into each and every section of nearby us where a best possibility can be created. And how it can be possible? It can only be possible if we have 100 of the things with us, and among them, we are just putting our efforts, and that, and among them, 5 or 10 will be coming out. And how we are just going to do that? Here, by this section, institution itself is supporting, faculty members are supporting, and all those are working in the direction to create this one. For that, institution has created the NISP policy. Institution itself adopted an NISP policy, and that NISP policy is going to help in many aspects to the particular candidate, to the particular student, or to the particular faculty member to just put up your initiative here and to convert the initiative into the form of startup and the entrepreneurship. So this is all about entrepreneurship. I have not taken so many stories. Those were already created as entrepreneur because you have already listened so many times. Aap logon ne sabhi jagah suni hui hai. But here is that. Now we are here to make your story, to put somewhere on Google. So abhi hamara target hai ki aap log apni stories create kare. You just put up your things, create it out. It's not too much stuff. It's simple. It's easy. We are working. We shall be working with you, and obviously the whole university will be supporting if you have certain kind of an idea. Put it up, create your story so that, so next time other people will be finding that you would have your story on the Google, so that Aral will be taking the illustration of that. This is exactly all about the NISP. So now the session is absolutely open to have a discussion about that.
Thank you, Pankaj sir.
Thank you, sir.
Students, if you have any question, you can ask. Dear participants, is there any question? Maybe ask during the session. Okay. So now the time of vote of thanks. First of all, no doubt there is an immense opportunity of entrepreneurship in India, and the talk delivered by sir emphasize upon national innovation and startup policy and what is in store for young students like you. And entrepreneurship is just not for about talking risk, but it is all about taking calculative risk, which can be defeat the uncertainty looming large any new startup. And in this context, various types of entrepreneurship, role of entrepreneur and entrepreneurship in economic development, private and government sector development also involved by it. And at the end, we at FOE, IIC, heartily extend thanks to Professor R.K. Dwivedi, Principal FOE, Tirthankar Mahavir University, our respected keynote speaker, Dr. Pankaj Goswami, sir, to give the precious time and spare their precious time with us with a knowledgeable session, and for Sakshi ma'am and all the stakeholder from the institute. Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot. Guys, I am just sharing a feedback form. Just fill it and you will get a certificate. If you have any problem, you just email me or just ping on FOEDC page. We will share the certificate with you. Thank you, Pankaj sir. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. And I my open invitation to all. So anybody is thinking to know more about that, anytime can easily contact me. Thank you.
ओके सर, ओके, थैंक यू, थैंक्स लॉट.